The Bristol Flyers Podcast.
Hello and welcome to the Bristol Flyers Podcast. It is our Christmas special!
Woo!
Christmas is here! Everyone loves Christmas. Give it a round of applause. Proudly sponsored by Web Gains, of course. Thank you very much for your support. I'm Joel Osborne, and normally this is the part of the show where I'd introduce my good friend and co-host Sam Hardy. But Sam's not here today, and that is because he is on his Christmas holidays. However, I'm not alone here in the studio, because I do have a good friend sat in Sam's seat filling in for him, and that is Buddy the Elf. Buddy, how's it going? All right, thanks. And also, I've got producer Dan over there. Producer Dan, how are you, sir?
Very well, thank you. Very well. How are you?
It's just me this week, so you're going to have to get a lot of airtime.
I know.
You get 75% of the airtime, as Nigel Farage would say.
Exactly, yeah. I get to kick Sam into the curb a little bit, and me and Buddy will be holding the ship for now.
How is preparations going for the big day?
Well, I'm packed. I'm just sort of prepped now. Everything's been wrapped. Everything is ready to go. So actually, I'm ahead of schedule, which is good.
And what are you up to this Christmas? Talk to us.
Well, I'm going to be at my brother-in-law's on the morning and then my family in the afternoon because me and my wife, we have no children, no kids. So we're the ones that have to do the moving around. So we're going to be splitting our time between her family and mine.
Amazing. Sounds good. You got anything on your wish list from the big man this Christmas? Anything?
Well, 3 points for Bristol City is always on my wish list on Boxing Day. Mm-hmm. And a big dub for Flyers at the end of the year. That's pretty much all I need, really.
Yeah, of course, Flyers, they take on Leicester Riders on the 28th of December. That's away from home, and you can watch down the British Basketball League YouTube channel as well. So just a quick rundown on how this episode is going to work out, because of course Dan and I are in the studio and there's no Sam either. So this is our big look back on 2023 as a whole. So we're here in the studio, we're going to do this link at the top of the show, and then we're going to throw to some highlights of the best moments of the Bristol Flyers podcast from January right up until now. And Dan, I gave you a little preview of this, didn't I, earlier on? We've got two packages. I wonder how much you love a package, right?
Oh, I love a package. You know me. And two for the price of one for this one. This is great. I'm very much looking forward to this.
Yeah, it should be great. There's a good chance to sort of look back and reminisce on all the funny moments from the podcast. We've got a lot of new listeners as well since we started in January, and so a chance for them to listen back to some of the absolute nonsense we used to talk about back then as well will be great.
And before we go any further, I have to say that the packages are great, and it's taken you a long time to put them together, so you know, I hope you get a bit of time off too, Joel. What are you doing for Christmas, because you are a busy boy?
Yeah, I do have some time off. I've got I got my brother and my sister-in-law coming down for a Christmas curry at the weekend, so nice. That'd be lovely. And then the big day, it's just myself and the parents, which would be lovely. And I'm taking some time off, yes, but we do have a game against Leicester Riders on the 28th.
Of course.
So I'll be working that. And then after that, there isn't a game. To my recollection, and I'm about to double check this on the Flyers schedule, because there have been a lot of schedule changes, but to my recollection, after the Leicester Riders game on the 28th, there isn't a game until the 5th of January, so nice. A little bit of time off there as well.
Well, that's good.
Of course, the British Basketball League trophy gets officially underway in January, which should be super exciting. The league will take a break, and we will play four games in the group stage for a chance to make the final four, which is at Birmingham at Utilita Arena. So a new format for everyone. That'll take some getting used to, but it should be super, super exciting indeed. Right, before we get to our first package and look back on all the favourite moments from January up until the end of last season, producer Dan, we thought it'd be quite good, because Sam's not here, is to do a little festive Flyers trivia, right? Do some little Christmas quizmas.
Yeah, just a little quizmas for you. Just a few questions, but yeah, they're quite tough.
So I
tested these on you, Joel. Some of them are quite tough.
Yeah, you did test them on me, and to be fair, it took me a little while to think about some of these. So there is five questions. Is that right? Five questions?
Five questions.
Five questions that producer Dan has put together. We're going to ask them to you now. And then while the packages are running later on, you can have a little think. And then we will reveal the answers at the end of the episode. So shall we get to our first question, producer Dan?
Yes, let's do it. Are you ready?
I am ready. I hope the listeners at home are ready as well.
Okay.
Here comes your first Quizmas Flyers quiz question.
And I have to say, all of these, don't go and Google it. That's not, you know, we're not here for that. You've got an hour to try and figure these out. So without Googling, your first question is, how many British Basketball League team logos have a basketball in them?
See, now I thought about this long and hard, and actually it was quite hard for me to even think about who the 10 teams are in the league off the top of my head without even Googling. So good luck trying to figure out how many basketballs are in there.
It shouldn't be a two-parter question, this, but it kind of is. So yeah, firstly, what teams are there in the British Basketball League, and how many of them have a basketball in their logo?
Yeah. So that is question one. How many teams have the basketball in their logo? Question two, producer Dan.
Okay, question two. Who scored the first Flyers points of 2023?
Ooh, that is a great question.
Short but simple, or is it?
Right, question number three.
Okay, nice and easy one in the middle, hopefully. Brad Green, tallest man on our roster. Who's the shortest?
Who is the shortest player on the Bristol Flyers roster? Another good question.
I can see Buddy's got his hand up, Buddy.
No,
that's fine.
So.
That's fine. No. I thought you had a question. Okay.
Where are we at? Question four.
Question four of five is this. Across 2023, which team do we have the best record against? So across 2023, tail end of last season and the start of this. So across the whole calendar year, which team do we have the best record against?
And now the big finale, and this one, producer Dan, might trip up a lot of people.
This is a killer. This is a difficult question. So at the time of recording, with two games still to go, how many points have the Bristol Flyers scored in 2023?
Great question.
Across the whole year, how many points have we scored?
From January up until Friday, December 22nd, before the Sheffield Sharks game. So there's obviously two games left. Great stuff. Well, have a think about those questions. That was a good little quiz. And we will reveal the answers to the questions at the end of our Christmas special. Right, producer Dan, I think it's time for us to get to our very first package. What do you think?
Yes, let's do it.
Right, without further ado, let's get to it. We're starting all the way back in January. This first package features highlights from the Bristol Flyers podcast from January 23 up until the end of the 22-23 season.
It's the Bristol Flyers podcast.
Hey Flyers fans, we want to say a huge thank you to our sponsors WebGains, who help make this podcast possible. WebGains is an affiliate marketing network who bring businesses and affiliates together to grow and succeed.
The Bristol Flyers are all about teamwork, and that's exactly what WebGains are about too. They're like the assist that helps your business score big.
Are you an aspiring entrepreneur or have a business of your own that sells products online? If so, WebGains is here to help. They connect businesses with top affiliates, from cashback giants like Top Cashback to niche bloggers in your vertical, who can promote your products and services, reaching a wider audience and driving more revenue.
And here's the slam dunk, Flyers fans. WebGains provides you with detailed reports and analytics to track the performance of your affiliate marketing campaigns, making it easy to see results of your hard work and investments.
Whether you're a local business or an international brand, WebGains has the expertise and network to take your marketing efforts to the next level. They're passionate about helping businesses grow, just like we're passionate about our team's success, Sam.
So if you're ready to skyrocket your online presence and drive more sales, visit webgains.com and see how they can assist you in scoring big in the world of affiliate marketing.
That's webgains.com, WebGains.com. Give your business the assist it needs with WebGains Affiliate Network.
This is the Bristol Flyers Podcast.
Before we want to get to introduce our guests for this week, got to give everyone a massive shout out at home for listening, because our numbers have shot up massively since we, since we made this podcast weekly. So thank you to you at home for tuning in, whether you're watching on YouTube or listening on the podcast feed. Every Wednesday now for the rest of the season, we'll be bringing you a weekly episode. No more breaks, Sam.
Have we had any Apple podcast reviews yet?
No, we haven't. And if the first person that gives us a rating or a review, an actual review that we can that can read, we'll read it out here on the podcast. What do you think about
that? Yeah, and you win a prize.
Pride. You win pride. You win pride. Since our last episode, we have got our first review.
Yes.
On the iTunes store, and it is from none other than Cider Sam.
Love that.
Anyone who listens to the Bristol Flyers podcast will know Cider Sam. He is a key member, a founding member of the Bristol Flyers supporters group. He was on our Bristol Flyers supporters group episode. We spoke to him at the open training episode. So a big listener of the podcast. He's only gone and left us a review here. Here we go. From Cider Sam. Just the boost you need on a Wednesday to get you through the rest of the week. The podcast always cheers me up with its light humour and is a good way to unwind after a difficult day. Great content, great guests, the best hosts. What more can you ask for? A must listen for any Bristol Flyers fan. Basketball emoji, flame emoji.
Now, ego officially tickled there, Joel. How do you feel about that, mate?
Incredible. Incredible. It's exactly what that's exactly the boost we needed here on the Bristol Flyers podcast. So thanks, Sam. Before we introduce our guest this week, Sam, obviously the last few weeks we've been asking fans to send in their reviews if they listen to the podcast on Apple Podcasts. And I'm very pleased to say we have two more. Shall I read out the first one?
I've heard one of these and I think it is absolutely brilliant.
Shout out Marky underscore CX on the podcast feed. Rated it 5 stars. Great stuff. Even Roy Keane would crack a smile listening to this.
Yeah, enjoyed that. Enjoyed that a lot.
And this second one, probably my favourite review we've had so far on the Bristol Flyers podcast. Massive shout out. They've kept themselves anonymous here. Bristol Aviation Geek. 5-star rating, so thank you very much for that. Joel and Sam are from the Royal Aeronautical Society in Bristol, and each week they break down all things flight-related. The podcast features a rotating cast of leading lights in the aeronautical industry. My favourite was Mike the Iceman Miller, who talked about his recent work on aircraft de-icing systems, from which he gained international recognition. I've already booked my seat for next week's show. Boarding starts at 6. See you there.
That is just so ridiculous.
What a credible review that was. You've both been kidnapped by two Caledonia Gladiator fans ahead of Friday's game, and you get one phone call to a fellow teammate to save yourselves and get back into the lineup. If they don't answer, you're not in the lineup for Friday. Who's the one person you're calling?
Out of all the people on the team, I would probably go with Corey. I think Corey answers one. You don't think Corey answers?
Yeah, I reckon.
You answer?
You know what? I'm saying VJ.
Should we try it now?
What, call VJ?
Get your phone out.
Let me FaceTime him.
Oh, FaceTime.
Here we go. FaceTime. Here you go.
Let's see if he'll pick up.
If not, you ain't playing, boy.
No, VJ.
Bro, VJ failed.
Oh, let's try Corey.
VJ failed.
Last try.
All right, so Corey Samuels. Corey Samuels.
I think Corey going to see it, and he'll be like, I wonder why they calling.
Let's give Corey Samuels.
You guys ain't playing on Friday, man.
These guys are bugging. I'll give it 2 more rings.
There's one. There's two.
Man. We ain't playing.
You guys ain't playing on Friday.
There's a reason I don't call none of them.
Last bit of news I got for you here, Sam. Flyers fan John Padgett, who's only posted in the Bristol Flyers supporters club, he's made his own custom t-shirt and he posted this video in the supporters club Facebook page.
New Bristol Flyers top created today. Looks rather nice, I think. Oh, what's that? Is that a QR code? And what's that do then? Let's have a look, shall we? So we take another phone, open the link, and hey, look, Bristol Flyers. How about that then?
Scan it on your phone. Scan it. Basically, it's for those that haven't, it's worked.
Hey, it worked.
It's worked. That's amazing. For those that are listening to the podcast, basically, Flyers fan John Padgett's only gone and made himself a t-shirt. The front of the t-shirt says Bristol Flyers, got the logo on it. It's got this QR code on the front as well. You scan the QR code and it takes you through to the Bristol Flyers homepage as tested right here on the podcast. Amazing. Well, Corey, we wanted to kind of show you some of the love that you are receiving on the from these school visits. We've got a selection of tweets here from some of the schools that you have visited during the BBL Ambassadors Project. Here's the first one. This one is from your visit to Wolves Court. Here's a look at the next one. You're getting so much love on social from some of these visits. Here's another one, this time from St. Werburgh's. This is another school that Corey visited, delivering another assembly. It's like the Corey Samuels World Tour. We should get like t-shirts made. made, and then you have like your tour dates of which school assembly you're going into next.
I used to work there.
Ventures That's, Academy.
Yeah, I worked there for a year, like during lockdown with my brother.
Wow.
And that, like, most of those kids, or pretty much all those kids in that picture, was like in my class as well. So
That is amazing.
That's amazing. One, That's so good. And I think if I've got some numbers here, 22 schools that you've visited so far. You were actually at a school this morning, weren't you?
Yeah, I was at my own primary school, like where I went. So like Begbrook, and that was sick. Like I'll say like the Ventures one, and that one's like obviously the most like meaningful, just because obviously I was like there like growing up, and I had like a picture when I was in like year one, and like, I showed it all the kids was going, oh my gosh, and then obviously the staff that was still there from back in the day, and like
same teachers.
There's a couple like yeah like receptionists cool. and stuff. It was like oh man,
yeah,
it was just crazy.
That's so great. Well, one Flyers fan in particular who you have sort of built an online friendship with is Amy Atkinson. She tweets you after every game. This all started, wasn't it? Because I think she wasn't too happy with your preseason predictions that you made, you know, on social, putting Flyers dead last. Now, every time the Flyers win a game, she's tweeting you straight away, isn't she?
I mean, right, yeah, literally straight away. And, she wasn't the only one, by the way, but, man, I love her persistence. She makes sure if I'm busy doing something and I haven't been able to catch up with action, I know Amy Atkinson is going to make sure that I know that the Bristol Flyers won.
But, Drew, you've not met her at all, have you?
No, never.
Well, I'll tell you what, Drew, today is your lucky day because we can phone Amy Atkinson right now on the podcast. I've given her a heads up that we're going to be ringing her from the podcast. However, I haven't told you that you are the studio guest for this week's episode. Come on, Amy, answer the phone.
Yeah, that's when she won't answer.
Come
now.
On, we need this.
Still ringing. I have told her to expect a call.
Hello.
Hi, is that Amy?
Hi, it is. Hi, Joel.
We were just talking about your tweets to a certain Drew Lasker that you send after every Flyers game after his pre-season predictions. Is that right?
Yeah, every game. Yeah, I haven't failed once, I don't think.
If you had one thing you wanted to say to Drew, what would that be?
Would you like to go back in time and change your prediction?
Well, it's funny you say that, Amy, because in the studio right now, we have none other than Drew Lasker sat right there next
I'm
to us.
Here. What's up, Amy?
Oh, my God.
I've traveled all through the mountains to come here to apologize in person. I told you I was coming.
You did. Oh, my gosh.
Amy, after a Flyers win, how quickly are you picking up that phone and tweeting Drew Lasker?
Quite quickly. I would say within 30 minutes, mostly.
Wow.
That is commitment right there.
I love the persistence.
What Drew was just saying to us, you got to keep it coming now. And also, he's noticed that you don't necessarily tweet him after Flyers lose games.
Hasn't happened for a while.
To be fair, she's not lying. It's not happened for a while. Amy, what have you made to the season so far? Obviously, Flyers on a 6-game win streak right now, their best ever win streak since joining BBL in 2014. How have you found it as a fan just supporting the team this season?
It's just been magical this season. I mean, every season as a Flyers fan, it's always exciting. You know, coach always puts together a really good team. But this season, there's something just really electric about it. That's the only kind of word that I can use. It's been a wild ride. And at the moment, you know, I took a screenshot on Sunday afternoon when we were top of the table before the Lions played. And I've shown it to every student in all my lessons this week.
Yeah, we were literally top of the table, weren't we, for about 48 hours. And then the Lions played and then they just overtook us again. Got to take advantage while we can, I guess.
Soak it up.
Absolutely.
Amy, are you coming to the next home game against Drew's Newcastle Eagles on the 17th?
Very sadly, I'm away.
No, you're not.
So
no.
I know. Yeah, we're away.
No,
perhaps it's hard to him.
Well, I was going to ask you if you had your bacon fingers at the ready for the game, because it's been a while since we had a last home game.
That's true.
I know. Maybe I could send them somehow, telepathy, maybe.
Yeah, that'd be good. If you could just post them through to us and maybe post one up to Newcastle.
I'll
for Drew
DM
as well.
You my postcode.
Great stuff. Amy, we're going to let you go, but we can't let you leave without plugging the Bristol Flyers supporters group. Of course, you know, we had you on the supporters group episode at the end of last season. Just tell us more about the Flyers supporters club and how any of the listeners can get involved with it on Facebook.
Sure. So it's a Facebook group. We just come together online to kind of share sort of thoughts and just sort of like get to know one another. We've got a really good core on there now, and there's new people coming every day. We're up to, I think, over 400 people now, maybe more. So it's just brilliant. It's a really good place to come and share your views on, you know, sort of the games, and just really enjoying the success that we're having at the moment with other Flyers fans.
Awesome. Great stuff. Thanks so much, Amy, for being such a great sport with us here on the Bristol Flyers podcast. And thanks for letting us phone you so late in the evening. I know it's normally part. We don't normally record in this time, I promise.
No, that's fine. Thank you very much for calling me.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Amy. We'll see you soon.
Okay. Bye, Drew.
Drew, you must be so sick of us now. Like every time, like, I've apologized so many times. Just leave me alone.
No, it's cool. It's cool. You guys got some great fans, and that's the type of support that you want. And you want to be able to have some friendly banter, and that's what it is. And we're having fun with it.
And joining us now is none that we spoke about on the podcast. It is the Young Hill brothers, Kobe and Corey. Fellas, welcome to the Bristol Flyers podcast. How's it going?
We're good. How are you guys?
Oh my god, that's a massive dunk! Corey Samuels with an alley-oop dunk! I'm so sorry! I was so excited. I'm finding it hard to interview here because these things are going off right now. Sheesh! That was outrageous.
30 seconds on the clock. Your time starts now. What's your favourite sports movie of all time?
Coach Carter.
Who's the one player that's most likely to turn up late to practice?
Coach has said a swear word, but we'll bleep it on the podcast. Who's turning up late to practice?
Leslie Angelani.
Who's the funniest guy on the team?
Brandon.
What actor would you play in a film about your life? Would you like to play you in a film about your life?
Tom Cruise.
What's your go-to karaoke song?
Come fly with me.
Are you a morning person or an evening person?
Morning.
Favourite away arena to coach in?
Leicester.
If you weren't a basketball coach, what would you be?
Economist.
What would the score be in a one-on-one between you and Nick Burns?
3-2.
Coach has taken it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Just short of Mike Miller's... give us a clap. Muted Dan's giving him a round of applause.
I like that.
He threw me off the whole who's late in practice.
We had another tweet. This time was from David at Habu. He is the head of brand for our principal partner, front of shirt sponsor at Habu. And he tweeted after the game on Sunday. People often ask me, hey, David, you have a pretty hectic schedule. How do you stay in peak physical condition? And he goes, well, my answer is always the same. I get the cheese and meat section with a Thatcher's Gold at the Bristol Flyers. Hashtag fitspiration, hashtag high performance, hashtag marginal gains.
Yeah, that is what our players eat, actually, on a daily basis. It's all they eat, actually, isn't it, Joel? Thatcher's cheese and a selection of meats. Delicious.
Massive shout out to Dave and the guys at Habu for their continued support of the club. And if you want your tweet to be featured on the Bristol Flyers podcast, do send them in. We want to hear, how do you like to enjoy Flyers basketball? Maybe tweet us in at Bristol Flyers and we'll feature them. Got one more thing to give a shout out to, by the way. When we were up in Cheshire, we had some great travelling support for that game, didn't we?
One person in particular, though, Joel. Very important to mention them.
Yep, good friend of the show. We had them on the podcast during our Christmas episode. Tom Waterton. Now, a lot of you may remember Tom Waterton. He's Mike Miller's player sponsor this season. He was on the road with us to Cheshire last week. He obviously came on our Christmas podcast. So we gave him a quick phone call and asked him to give us his air raid siren noise, which he does at game days alongside his little one. But he was at the game on Sunday, and he was making that noise in Cheshire, and everyone thought it was an air raid siren. You could hear it so clearly through the broadcast.
He actually told us he was going to the game when I saw him last week, and I completely forgot, but then I was watching it, and then the first free throw that went through, I heard it come through. I was like, oh my goodness, that is amazing. We got a little clip of it, Joe, haven't we?
Yeah, should we take a little listen?
Have a little listen to this.
Malcolm Delpech, Leslie Smith. I thought there was an air raid going on there.
I was diving under the table. Yeah. I don't know if you can hear that at home, but
the world famous air raid siren
on the road. Amazing.
This past week was April Fool's Day. And as always, most sports clubs, brands on social media like to play April Fool's jokes on some of their fans. And the BBL was not short of April Fool's Day jokes. Here's a look at the first one. This one is from BBL Daily. And they said, Alan Partridge star Stephen Coogan is leading an investment group to bring a BBL team to East Anglia, the Norfolk Knights.
To be honest, I'd like that. That'd be great.
Here's another one from Courtsider. They said, Michael Jordan is in negotiations to invest in a BBL franchise. Hashtag British basketball.
I love that. To be fair, it'd be fun for him. It'd be a bit like Ryan Reynolds doing the thing with Wrexham Town Football Club.
Yeah, I mean, it would, to be fair. I wouldn't mind it. Here's our final April Fool's gag. This one came from Sheffield Sharks, and they chimed in on the action. They said, breaking news, Mike Tuck resigns to return for the Sheffield Sharks lineup. And they put a quote here from Mike Tuck as well. With Sharks doing so well recently, it's the perfect time for me to come out of retirement.
I love that.
Well, they could have done with him on Sunday when they lost to the Cheshire Phoenix, couldn't they?
Oh, man.
They lost to them with six players.
I know. Cheshire Phoenix, mate, all right, you guys, from your perspective, six players playing a full 40-minute match. How's that for load?
Unideal.
We've got another question come through here, and this one is from a certain Coach Burns, and he sent us a voice memo for a message.
Oh, wow.
Should we take a listen?
Oh, God.
Hi guys, Coach Nick here. I have a question for Roy. I assume he's been away so long, he must have been looking for his jump shot. I just wanted to know if he's found it or not. Love you, Roy.
Nick Burns, you know. Nick Burns getting spicy. That's kind of disrespectful, but...
so have you found your jump shot, Roy?
I found the gym. I found 8 hours sleep. I found nothing to do with basketball. Going to teach other people it instead.
You just saw Coach Burns.
And he just walked past him. He didn't say nothing.
We got one last question we want to get to here on this twin telepathy quiz. Let's put it to the test. Marcus, I want you to think of any number between 1 and 10. Malcolm, okay. You are going to write number Marcus is thinking of on the board here in the studio. Malcolm's written a number. Marcus, what number are you thinking of?
Six.
Damn. Malcolm, turn the board over.
Toughy.
Four.
Number four.
You know what? My first number was six, to be fair.
Oh, why don't you go with it?
I overthought.
You told me not to change my number. You can't change yours either.
There we go. Here's an interesting subject I wanted to talk to the both of you about. I actually had a fan come up to me at the Cheshire Phoenix game on Friday. They wanted to see if we could get some Flyers player chants going. Well, I tell you what, fellas, I've done some more thinking here, and I've got an idea for another chant that could work for not only Bristol Flyers fans, but it could also work for Sheffield Sharks fans. We'll see what you guys think. Are you guys ready?
You're going to hate it.
Like it, I like it, I like it, I like it, like, here we go. Malcolm Delpech in the post.
He hates
absolute
it.
Like tumble, absolute tumbleweed going across here. Marcus got this shot.
Put that back where you found it.
That was last week's word of the week. However, it does mean we've got a word available on our wheel right here. And Dan, as our guest for this week's podcast, we would like you to come up with a word to add to our wheel. What do you think?
So I was just looking around trying to find something. I've randomly just spotted a cassette tape. I don't know what it is. It's like a Lego cassette tape. I didn't know whether to go with cassette tape or a fireplace. I think fireplace would be harder than cassette tape to get in. I can't see the reference in basketball. So I'm going to go with fireplace.
Fireplace?
That's
actually fireplace. A really good word.
He's so hot, he needs something like that, Joe. You have to get in there, aren't you?
You just put him in the fireplace.
Yeah, right. I like that.
I'm going to add this to my wheel. Where are we? Fireplace. On the wheel.
I like that.
There's some great words on here. There's all sorts of words. It was the word hoya, thanks to Malcolm last week. Whole bunch here. Right, Sam, are you ready? It's time for us to spin the wheel. Oh no.
Uh-oh.
Oh. Oh, oh no! It's landed on Hoyer, thanks to Malcolm Delpech last week.
Thank you, Malcolm. That is amazing. Good luck, Joel.
Oh, I got to get the word Hoyer into the playoffs. Oh, like probably the biggest game of the season. I've got to try and get that word in there. That's going to be an absolute nightmare.
I love it.
It's got to be on a Delpech play as well, I suggest.
I reckon. Stolen away by King. And here's Malcolm Delpech. Jams it in. On the buzzer. And that one had a bit of Hoyer on it. What do you reckon, Dan? If we gave this wheel one more spin, would you be up for...
I can't promise anything.
Right, I've added dunk shot to the wheel. Are you ready, Sam? Let's give this wheel one more spin. Here we go, then.
Hey, you've given that quite a spin there, Joe.
I have. Please land on dunk shot. Please land on dunk shot. Please land on dunk shot. Please land on dunk shot.
Hey, it's
landed
in!
On dunk shot!
I have no evidence for this.
Yes!
You'll have to watch it later.
It's landed on dunk shot. I can't believe it. Okay, Dan, if you can get dunk shot into your commentary for Sunday's game, Sky Sports, Sheffield Sharks versus Leicester Riders, somehow, we would love you forever. See what
I can do, Dan, and we'll see what I can do. Let's take a look at the starting fives, and Zach Jackson has all sorts of ways to finish in the mid-range. Can get to the basket for a big dunk. Shot 40% from three and 80 from the line. He's a versatile scorer.
Earlier on in the season, our snapper was able to grab a great photo of Tevin Ollison. And if this doesn't win best hair on its own, I don't know what does. Because this photo here, taken of Tevin Ollison, it looks like, I think a player stood behind him. If you're watching this podcast on YouTube, you can see it looks like Tevin Ollison has a full mullet on the go here. Outstanding.
He says he's going to go get this haircut one day, Joe, just for you, mate.
Yeah, he should. I think it rocks it. I think it suits him really well. If you squint really tightly, you can see this looks just like a mullet. That's amazing. If you're listening to the podcast, see if you can give it a Google. Maybe we'll clip this up for the video version of the podcast so you can see what we're talking about. But unbelievable hair. I don't know why that doesn't win best hair in itself.
Bristol Flyers final event and the live podcast.
How are you? My name is Joel Osborne. I'm very pleased to be joined, as always, by the partner in crime, Sam Hardy.
Hello. How are we all doing tonight? Everyone okay?
Yeah.
Sam, can you believe it? We made it to the live audience episode.
Flipping air. What is it? Has everyone enjoyed the season this year? Have we enjoyed seeing all those dubs on the score sheet? Yes, we have.
Our most successful ever season as a Bristol Flyer since joining the BBL. A number of records broken, Sam. Incredible season as a whole. Highest ever finish of third. Most single season wins. Highest ever win percentage. The earliest we've ever secured our place in the playoffs. The records just keep coming this year. It's been amazing.
I've loved every single second. I'm sure all of you have too. But we couldn't have done it without your support. So please give a cheer for each and every one of you tonight.
Yes! Mike, final thing from you, mate. I don't know if you know this, but last week on the podcast, we held our Supporters Club End of Season Awards, and the fans voted your British accent on episode 21 as their podcast moment of the season. Can we get another little preview of the English accent right here, right now, in the season finale, please?
Hello, my name is Mike Miller. I'm a point guard for Liverpool.
Oh, piss off, mate. Let's hear it for Mike Miller.
Who next?
Now, VJ, this is your first, this has been your first season in the UK. You've played with so many great teams in the past. You've played with future NBA All-Stars. But in terms of this group of players, like, where does this group of players rank in teams that you've been amongst during your professional career?
Nah, apart from the basketball stuff, this is probably... No, this is probably one of the best group of guys that I've ever been around. Like Mike said, we just gel from the start, and that's not very common. And in the professional game, period. This felt like almost like a college team. as I was telling Sam earlier, so we spent so much time together off the court, and I think it really translated to the floor. And you know, people doubted us from the season. As a newcomer, I didn't really know a lot about the league, but I can tell how much it meant to these guys. And we worked so hard every day, and it was just fun to be around them. You know, things was up and down. I can say this is probably one of the best, if not like the best, like professional team that I've been on, where, you know, we just look forward to see each other the next day, no matter how the games and stuff went. So.
How proud have you been of Jelani this season, Mum?
I don't have any words. I'm just so, so proud of him. So proud of him. He's done so well.
And to be able to actually watch him play in person, what does that mean to you rather than having to, you know, watch it through the telly at stupid o'clock in the morning?
Well, I came to Bristol and I donned my pink T-shirt. And I had a horn. And my sisters said in London, that's all we could hear. Right? And even Jelani said, Mum, was that your horn I could hear? And I was like, yes, because that's what I've always did before he went to America. We traveled all over. We had dustbins, we had dustbin lids, we had forks and plates. And we just went with all our instruments. So the horn was nothing compared to what we used to do. But the fact that we could even just come and see it live, I mean, you know, I came to one game and then I said, oh, I'm coming again at the weekend. And Jelani was like, you're coming again? Yeah, I'm coming again. And, you know, I've been down quite a few times and it's just been so electric. And I just want to thank Bristol for, you know, letting Jelani be part of your family. And it was really, really good. Thank you.
This is the Bristol Flyers podcast. That was absolutely amazing. Like I said, there were so many memories from that. And making that package, it was so hard to actually pick out the best moments because so many moments could have actually gone in there, Dan.
Yeah, you watch that and you think, wow, what a great year. That's half the year.
Yeah.
That's only half of it. Yeah, half of the podcast we've done. Yeah, fantastic.
Yeah, so there were some great memories in there, all culminating in that live audience episode, which I think personally for me, that was probably the podcast highlight of the year for myself.
I think it's one of my highlights of the year, full stop, Joel. Aww. My entire year. I really enjoyed that. Meeting everybody, putting names to faces, and, you know, seeing the fans with, you know, with the players and stuff. It was great. Yeah. Really, really good.
It really was a great way to round out what was our most successful ever season in the British Basketball League. Highest ever league finish. I mean, I said it all there in the package earlier, but incredible achievements. And obviously, announcing our entry into the European North Basketball League as well.
And if Jelani's mum didn't bring a tear to your eye, you're a cold-hearted devil. That was a beautiful moment.
Yeah, true. Yeah, I'll tell you what, Jelani's mum actually came down. She still comes to Flyers games this season.
Good.
She was. I saw her at a game very recently. Shout out Jelani's mum, if you're listening to the podcast still. But yeah, it was really, really good.
Nice.
Buddy the Elf, did you have a highlight from that first half of the season at all? No? Didn't think so.
Yeah.
No. Not very talkative today, is he?
No. Dan? It's an upgrade on Sam, though.
It definitely is an upgrade on Sam. It feels like a lot quieter in here without me. I love the face he's pulling as well. If you listen to the podcast, it's essentially it's the cover of the movie. He's got his fists like bunched together and his mouth wide open.
How does it look? Look at you there and then together. Wow.
Amazing.
Could be brothers.
Yeah, we could be. I've even worn red today for Santa Claus for festiveness as well. We should probably get back to where we were, Stan.
Probably, yeah.
Right, time for us to take a look back at the second half of the year, 2023, which consists of... Because we took a short break, didn't we, Dan?
We did.
Over the summer. So the podcast took a break after the end of our live audience episode. It came back in August, and then we ran until where we are now on a weekly basis with a brand new partner in Web Gains, thanks to Web Gains. Shout out Web Gains. And yeah, let's get to it. Here's some of the best moments from the 2023-24 season to date. Hope you enjoy. This is the Bristol Flyers podcast. Hello, welcome back to the Bristol Flyers podcast, now proudly sponsored
by Web Gains.
Sam, how good does that sound?
Joel, we spent all last season talking about needing Stevie O'Devereaux to get us a new sponsor for the podcast, and he's only gone and done it, hasn't he?
He's only gone and knocked it out of the park. Yes, we are proudly sponsored by Web Gains now. Thank you so much for tuning into our first episode of the brand new season. Plenty of cool things you want to try this season, of course, with the new sponsor in board as well. And one of the new things we do have this season, we've only gone and got a mic for podcast producer Dan. Dan, how's it going?
Hello. Happy to be here.
Here he is. He's a voice of God here on the podcast. We will get a camera on you at some point, when we just realise that you actually haven't got a light, so we can't see you. You're just sat in the dark at the moment, but we will get a camera on you in a future episode down the line.
I'm so glad that we also have control over Dan speaking, though, because he can sometimes talk nonsense, Joel, so it's good that you can turn him off and on whenever you want.
I don't know about that. I don't often talk that much.
Brilliant. Thanks, Dan. The league's communications department sent us a naming conventions document when they announced the new British Basketball League rebrand.
Right.
And the league confirmed that it was dropping the abbreviation BBL. So to help us make sure that we don't use those three letters here on the podcast this season, we're excited to introduce a brand new segment to the podcast. It's called the BBL Bucket. So here is my BBL bucket. As you can see, there is a big cross for the old British Basketball League logo. This is my BBL bucket right here. Anytime one of us says BBL on the podcast from here on out, you have to reach into the jar, the bucket, the BBL bucket, and draw out a forfeit.
Now, Joel, it wouldn't be a podcast without a question from Matt Hardy from BBL Daily.
Shout out, Matt Hardy.
That's his ex name.
He says the quotation mark. That's how you are. I apologize.
Joel, that's a direct quote.
You said those three letters, yeah, but which means you get to draw out of our lovely bucket. Where's the bucket? The bucket? There it is.
I don't like this rule because that is the name of his ex account.
Did you say the three letters or not?
No. No, I didn't.
I mean, you can run the tapes if you like.
Run the tape.
All right, Sam is going to pick out a forfeit from... You can't look at them.
I can't see him. I was just going to...
Okay. Out comes the forfeit. You've drawn one. What does it say?
I mean, absolutely fine by me.
Show the camera.
It is down a fresh water on next week's episode.
Oh dear. Anyone who listens to the podcast knows that by fresh water, we mean alcoholic beverage.
Do you know what? I'll take that. I don't mind that.
Before we introduce our guest this week on the podcast, should we get this forfeit out of the way now, shall we?
Joel, I still don't agree with how it went down, but yeah, that's fine. If you weren't here last week, we recommend going back and listening, but Joel has introduced something to the table. We're not actually allowed to say what it's called.
It's called the British Basketball League Bucket.
Yeah, but look, turn around. What does it say on it?
And every time you refer to the former name of the abbreviation of the British Basketball League, you have to reach into the bucket and do a forfeit. Sam said the three letters last week, long story short. He drew a forfeit. The forfeit was he has to down a fresh water. Now, we are during office hours and we do promote responsible drinking. So instead of a super fresh water, Sam, we've got you.
What have you got me?
A Heineken Zero, non-alcoholic alcohol.
Oh, I'll take that. Yeah, good. Oh, it's still cold as well. It's so hot in here. I'm very happy to have a cold drink. John, actually, I suck at downing, so this is going to be terrible for everyone.
Here we go, then. This will be the best part of the podcast. If you listen to the video version of the podcast feed, Sam is well underway, and he is downing his drink. Here he goes. He's still going.
Wow.
God, Sam.
Wow.
That's some great technique. Someone has said they're very bad at downing a drink, you've absolutely nailed that.
Fair play, Sam.
Congratulations.
Wow.
Well done. There we go. Well, that's the first forfeit of the season. I'm sure many more to come. How's it feel, Sam?
I'm crying.
We had a conversation when we was eating today, like talking about like chips, what Americans call fries.
Yeah.
Yeah, about like what dishes make sense. And I think it was like Corey, he was out here having like pizza with mayonnaise, and we was like, what? Like, what's going on here? I was looking at him so sideways about this. But then it came up with like the chips, like, do you know about chips poutine?
Poutine, like chips, yeah, and gravy.
Yeah,
and
yeah. So they're like, nah, like there's no way, like why would they do that?
Well, the and Americans, I'm saying, said are you that.
Yeah, but I thought it came from that side.
Wait, cheesy chips and gravy is amazing.
It's crazy. But
Then what is it? Raf said something with what is it? Chips and bread. What is it called?
Like a chip butty.
Chip butty. Yeah. Raf was like, that hits.
You put a bit of ketchup in the chip butty as well.
That's what he said. Yeah, I don't know, but it's just carb on carb.
We need to talk about something that you've introduced to the players over the last couple of years of the team, and that is Scopa.
It's Scorpa.
Scorpa.
Yeah.
Scorpa. So. A lot of people usually of like away games, you know, your standard team, they might get the Uno out, you know, they'll play a bit of video games maybe. But you've introduced Scorpa to the team.
Yeah.
Scorpa.
Yeah.
To the team. Talk us through it. What is Scorpa?
So Scorpa is a Italian card game.
He's got the cards I've as well. Cards he's, here. He's like he just pulled them out. I asked him to bring the cards with him to the show.
So I've got them here. So essentially the aim of the game is, you need to collect as many cards as you can. There's certain rules, that there's a lot of rules, so I won't go into all the ins and outs, but so basically you have certain cards that have certain ratings. So this is an 8, the woman is...
Hold it down a bit lower, a bit higher,
the
there
eight.
You go.
And then, for example, this is a 5, the king is the 10, this is a 1. If you have a card on the floor and it's on the table and you pick up, you can only pick it up with the same card. So you pick it up and then you keep the cards to yourself. And then there's a point system. So you have dinari, which is a gold. So the team with the most golds gets a point. Then you've got primiera, which is a point system. So whoever's got most of like 7s, 6s, 5s get a point. And then whoever gets the most cards gets a point, and then each scorpa is a point, and then there's one special card that everyone loves and everyone looks for, and it's called the Sette Bello, and this is the most important card of the game, because if you get this card then you get a guaranteed point as well. So whenever you play the game, look at the rules, definitely look at it. It's great to like play with your family or with friends as well, and yeah, it's just great fun. And there's rules online, so I would definitely advise going on it because it's great fun, great little game.
What about the British food? Have you tried any of the British food yet?
I don't even know what besides the fish and chips kind of thing. I don't know really what would you call it, like, because people was asking me like, hey, how's the British food here? And I'm like, I honestly don't know if I've eaten it because I just don't know what it is.
Well, Tijon, it's funny you say that because we have a great segment teed up for you right here on the podcast, because we're going to introduce to you right here on the pod some British snacks. And we wouldn't be talking about snacks without our resident snack expert at the Bristol Sport Office. And did I tell you, Sam, that we have Matt Charles in the Bristol Sport Office? He absolutely loves a snack.
That's all you talk about on this podcast is how much Matt Charles likes a snack. So with that in mind,
so we couldn't think of anyone more perfect to help us introduce British snacks to you than the snack king himself. Matt Childs joins us right now on the Bristol Flyers podcast.
Let's hear it from Matt.
Yes, here he comes. It is the snack king, Matt Childs himself. Matt works in the Bristol Sport office in support services. Matt, just squeeze in on there on the end of the desk. Matt, how's it going?
Very, very well. Nice to be on the podcast and introducing British snacks.
British snacks.
Snacks.
I'm sure he's going to have a feast of a time here.
It's good. It's time for Tijon Lucas to try British snacks for the very first time. Here we go. First up, we've got some Scotch eggs. Here we go. Let's have some immediate thoughts there, Tijon. What do you think of a Scotch egg? Are you a fan?
It's not that bad.
It's not that bad. Coming up next, who wants to try a pork pie?
Looks like a little cake.
It is a little cake. A little pork surprise cake.
Tijon trying a pork pie right now.
Our nutrition expert is going to be livid after seeing this, Joe.
It's a very heavy pork influence today on the snacks. What are your thoughts on a pork pie, Tijon?
Needs a little salt.
Needs salt. We've got Twiglets right here on the Bristol Flyers podcast. Have you ever had a Twiglet before?
I've seen them, but I've been hesitant on getting them for so long. I've been like, I want it, but I'm like, nah.
So they're little sticks of like crispiness, but they're covered in like Marmite. Have you ever heard? You must have heard of Marmite, right?
Definitely not.
Well, Snackman Matt is going to introduce you to Twiglets over there. What do you think of a Twiglet, Tijon?
Very mid.
They're mid. I think this is the UK's answer to beef jerky. and that is Mr. Porky's pork scratchings. give it a smell first. Oh no, he's gone straight for it. Oh, here he goes. He's in there.
They're crunchy.
They are crunchy. Oh,
he likes them, boy.
He's digging in for another. Wait. Final snack we have here. And this one is a treat, Tijon, because we have Jaffa Cakes. Tijon Lucas trying his very first Jaffa Cake.
A little chocolate on the
little bottom. Chocolate, a little orange.
Okay. Here we go.
Oh, I love a Jaffa Cake.
What do you think, Tijon? How do you rate it?
It's actually pretty good.
Yeah, there we go. He loves the Jaffa Cake. We got there in the end, didn't we?
Flipping out.
We found a snack that Tijon Lucas likes, and he loves Jaffa Cake. We just grabbed you, Brad, actually, from a Flyers half-term holiday camp because you and the whole team were down there at Cottam School earlier today doing a player visit, weren't you?
Yeah. So we got to practice a little bit, get some shots up, have the kids see like kind of the day-to-day things we do at practice. Then afterwards, we got to do a little Q&A with them, talk with them. And then I was lucky enough to play one-on-one versus quite a few of them. And I came out undefeated today. So
I'm so glad you did. Imagine if you didn't. Get that kid signed up.
Imagine. That'd be hilarious.
You were saying before that you were swatting kids to the halfway line when they were trying to shoot. So
hey, it's got to be done. No easy stuff up in here. Do you know what I mean?
But you got to enjoy like just their enthusiasm with getting their shot blocked, just being out there. Like, I mean, that's what makes it really worthwhile, is being able to just play, like block a shot and have them be like, oh my God, like good job. Like, yeah. It really makes you understand like how big it is to them to just be out there with them.
I had a chance, Sam, to look through some of the previous episode comments. And I know we always say, leave a comment in the comment section below. We'll read them out on air. We never read them out on air. So I'm going to read them out on air right now, real quickly, before we introduce the guest.
Okay, what you got for me, Joe?
First one, Paul Bazant left a comment on our last episode with Brad Green, which says, another great show, but who gets the editorial on my question? And I know why they've asked that question. It's because they want us to say the B, and the L in the former abbreviation of the league to do a forfeit. So that is why, Paul, sorry.
So it's Joel. Joel gets the editorial on the question.
Yeah, I get the editorial because I'm not doing a forfeit. We've done well enough to do a forfeit for a while now.
Yeah, I think it's going to be ingrained, which makes that sort of bucket a little bit.
Well, we'll find out. You never know. It's still there if you need it. Where is it, damn it? It's over there somewhere. Last comment to read out here. This one was from our episode with Flyers CEO Lisa Knights, from Phil Whitlock, from our partners at the Sport Clinic. Shout out, Phil. Which says, Joel's got a bit of Howard Cosell about him when he did the news in his American accent. More, please. Do you remember that one?
Yeah, you sounded, I'm going to be kind here, atrocious.
I heard a lot of people say I sound like Rob Palinostro from the Leicester Riders. You heard that one?
I'm not saying Rob sounds atrocious, by the way. That's not what I'm saying.
Rob, if you're watching, hi.
I love actually Rob does his comms for some of the games down in Ealing. He does what you do for, you know, some of the...
Yeah, he does. He's amazing. He's
done a couple one of my favourite. He's so funny. Is this something you did in one of ours, the quote he made?
Oh, yeah. It's the sound effects he always does. Watch Rob Paternoster on commentary. It's the whoosh, what, and watch this. Whoosh. And the best one was the Tijon Lucas assist to Brad Green. It's like, oh, we love the round the back pass. Whoop, round the back, right to Green. I was like, yes.
Wow, what a pass. We love that around the back pass. Lucas had foul trouble, but watch this. Whoop, around the back, right to Green. And Green will finish it with ease.
Before we actually get into the episode, TJ, we obviously have to reference that last episode where we had you on. And at the end of the episode, you suggested an idea for us the next time we had you here in the studio. Sam, should we take a listen to this?
I'm coming soon. I'm coming there with fish and chips in hand. Don't worry about that. I'm eating it right next to y'all. Don't worry about that one.
Love it. We're bringing the chips to the studio. I'd love to hear it.
He said he's going to sit right next to us. I'm expecting him to bring it for us, Joel. That's what I want, all right?
You buying, yeah?
Oh, yeah. It's on me for the first one. It's on me.
I'd love to see it. I can confirm, TJ, that you've come empty-handed.
We've got our intern Ash in the house. He's just joined us probably a month or a bit ago. He's on the commercial team, an absolute legend. He's coming down to watch the podcast. And what would make him more of a legend is if he orders some fish and chips that arrive by the end of the episode. Otherwise, you don't pass your probation, mate. So you better get this sorted, all right?
Okay, so we're getting one small cod and chips, please. One mushy peas, please. It looks like our fish and chips have arrived.
Hey now.
Right here in the studio.
Hey now.
Come on in, Ash. This bring them in.
2023, people. You can order food right to your podcast.
Here is intern Ash. Say hello, Ash, to the cameras. Shout out, Ash.
What a legend.
Would you like to do the honours and open up the lovely treats we have here? This is the content everyone's been waiting for. Trajan Jacob is finally trying some mushy peas. He's dipped his chip into it. TJ, what do you think?
Not bad.
It's not bad, eh?
Not bad.
The fish and chips finally arrived. Here we go. 30 seconds on the clock, Les. Your time starts now. Who is your biggest inspiration?
My mother.
What is your favorite clothing brand?
Mine. Yeah.
What are you having for dinner tonight?
Nothing.
How do you feel about cranberries?
Cranberries? I like the juice.
What noise does a cow make?
I'm not saying that way.
Do you believe in ghosts?
Of course.
Which celebrity annoys you the most?
Kevin Hart.
What's your go-to party trick?
Dancing.
Xbox or PlayStation?
Xbox.
There we go. I'm quite disappointed you avoided that question about the cows.
Oh, cow.
Yeah. Do the cow now and we'll let it go.
Yeah, let it go. So that counts for... That counts,
yeah. Right.
I got my boys RGB, Tevo, Ollison. Tell me one thing that happened tonight that you loved.
We came out and we responded well. We bounced back from the 3 losses and I think we had fun tonight. That was the most important thing.
Pasquale needs to do his best impression of Joel Osborne because he loves that.
Welcome, Bristol Flyers fans. This is the Bristol Flyers podcast live from Lublin.
That's TJ, give us one more thought. Give us one more thought, my boy. Give us one more thought.
Big Dub came here, got the job done. You know what I'm saying? Nothing but a thing. We out of here in the morning.
Love that. Guys, we will see you soon. Thank you so much for tuning in to the Bristol Flyers podcast.
But do you know what? While we're here, we might as well give just a couple of seconds to that dunk that has gone everywhere against Sheffield. That was crazy. Do you know what? I'm watching it. We want to talk about it all, but I'm watching. Les's pass is lovely, but it almost bobbles. You don't quite catch it clean to begin with, right?
Yeah, so honestly, I didn't think I was going to actually get the back door. I mean, we do it in practice, but like, I didn't know he was like, I was going to be that wide open, so I bobbled it. And as I was like trying to grab the ball and look towards the rim, I saw space. So I was like, well, I'm going full speed. He in the semicircle. I might as well try it and see what happens.
Yeah,
and
see
then
where I'm at with it.
And then now the pictures and all that, y'all see what happened. Yeah. And I had to style a little bit because, you know, why not? I'm already up there. I might as well hang around for a little bit. Right. You know,
was that one of the biggest dunks of your career, do you reckon?
Yeah, so it's actually crazy. I had one in high school my senior year. My boy threw me a lob and it looks bad, but the guy's like face actually hit my, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And like
I don't know what you're saying. Can you explain? No, I'm joking.
And his neck like popped back, and it's a picture of like me dunking on the kid where like my stuff is on his face, and like I'm.
Oh no!
Okay, there's the picture. I've just seen this picture of TJ Duncan. We'll put it up on screen in the edit so you guys can see it. But essentially, this defender has a mouth for the Trajan Jacobs junk. So
he had to go home to his parents after that.
It's crazy because that school is a private school, and we just happened to play him like a little one-off game or whatever. And I don't know this, but apparently. The next team, his rival school, they blew it up.
Yeah,
and hung the picture all around the gym. Oh, so when he walked in, that's all he saw.
Oh God! Ultimate troll. Trajan Jacob, everyone. Let's say
TJ.
This is the Bristol Flyers podcast.
Oh wow! Incredible.
Love it. That's amazing.
Yeah.
That is the whole year. Finally, that is the whole year sorted of Flyers podcast now.
Yeah, and there were so many sections in there that I just wish I could get in there as well. If we put together like all the highlight moments, I mean, it could be hours.
It could be a 4-hour review of the podcast.
Well, you could go and listen to all 60 odd episodes right now if you wanted to. They're all still there on the podcast feed, all major podcast providers, and on YouTube. You go check them out. Let us know what your favorite moment was of the year. Time for us to get to these quiz question answers, producer Dan.
Yes. Okay.
Let's fire away. Question one.
So, question one was, without Googling, how many British Basketball League teams' logos have a basketball in it?
Six out of 10.
Six out of 10. And do you want the full list?
Yeah, let's hear it.
London Lions.
Yeah.
Bristol Flyers.
Mm-hmm.
Cheshire Phoenix. Trying to remember my own list now.
Newcastle Eagles.
Newcastle Eagles.
Caledonia Gladiators.
Caledonia Gladiators and Surrey.
Surrey Scorchers, yeah. Little ball in the flame, isn't
exactly. They? That's the six. That's the six out of 10. If you got that right, well done. That's 1 point to you.
That is a very tough question as well, by the way.
Took a bit of thinking, didn't it? Without Googling as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, to figure out other 10 teams without Googling, I'll say, is tough. But.
Correct.
Right, question number two.
Okay, question two is who scored the first Flyers points of 2023? VJ King. Yes.
What a guy, by the way.
The king.
He came back to London last week to take on the London Lions in the Euro Cup for his team, Hamburg Towers now. And they won by 2 points.
Wow.
So shout out to VJ King.
Nice.
And the Hamburg Towers. Okay. Right, question number three.
Question three. I asked you, this was the question where it was Brad Green being the tallest man on our roster. Who is the shortest? Well, that would be Corey Samuels.
Corey Samuels.
Who isn't short. He's 6 foot. But yeah. It just goes to show the giants that we play with. Question four. Across 2023, which team do we have the best record against? 5-0, baby. Plymouth City Patriots this year. Flyers have played 5, won 5 against our local rivals.
Oh, we love playing Plymouth City Patriots.
And, we do.
We love beating Plymouth City Patriots. And everyone loves the Southwest Derby.
We do. It kind of leaves us like this. Isn't it? When we play Plymouth.
That's how we are.
We're like kind of like Buddy the Elf.
Yeah, yeah, that's exactly how I am after watching Flyers be Patriots.
Yes, exactly.
Right, question
and then
number
finally,
five.
Now you don't know the answer to this, Joel. Question number five. At the time of recording, with two games still to go this year, how many points have the Bristol Flyers scored in 2023?
And does this include, this obviously include European games.
Yep.
All league games, trophy playoffs. Does it include preseason games?
No, not preseason. So just the games that mattered. League, playoffs, trophy, Europe.
Okay. I'm going to say 3,750 points.
But the answer is 4,154.
Oh, wow. That was miles off.
That's a whole lot of buckets.
That's big. That is a whole lot of buckets. Well, that's going to do it for this week's episode of the Bristol Flyers podcast, and that's going to do it for the year. Of course, we are taking a break through the Crimbo Limbo, so we'll see you in January. For myself, from Buddy the Elf, from the entire Brandvox team behind the scenes, pushing buttons with producer Dan, we wish you all a very Merry Christmas, and we'll see you in 2024 for the Bristol Flyers podcast.